A mother tries to convince her four-year-old little boy that he's a little girl. This is sick and twisted, and I want to talk about it. Because recently, I watched a trailer that kind of went viral. It's a trailer for the new show, Transhood. It's an HBO Max show. Of course, we wouldn't expect anything less from HBO Max after their, movie, Unpregnant and the likes. They're trash. HBO Max is not somewhere you want to be going for good content, that's for sure. But this trailer, I watched it and it disturbed me. Like, it disturbed me to the point where I was thinking about it and then it got me angry. And then I was like, this is sick and this is twisted, and I need to use my platform to be able to speak about this, because if I'm not using it to speak about things that are important, then what am I doing? So I want to talk about it. First, I want to show you this trailer.
Good morning. Today we choose to recognize, honor, love, and celebrate anyone here who would claim their identity publicly as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, or questioning, intersex, pansexual, asexual, or any category that I've left out.
This is Phoenix.
Do you want to tell everyone
if you're a boy or a girl?
I just want to tell them that I'm a girl.
Okay, you can tell them that.
Okay. Phoenix would like you to know that she's a girl and she prefers she and her pronouns.
This way.
May you be well, safe, and whole. We honor you exactly as you are.
The biggest thing that struck me when I was watching this trailer is that this whole thing, like this ceremony, has the veneer of love, right? It has the veneer of love and acceptance and all that, right? That's what the world tries to tell you this is all about, right? This is what the culture tries to tell you. This is about love. This is about acceptance. But in order for us to be truly loving, we need to have truth. A love founded in lies and deception and distortion is no love at all. And so you see this little boy, right? His mom's trying to convince him he's a little girl. And look, it blows my mind that even people that support transgenderism and think that's a good thing would even contemplate that a child can make that assertion themselves. What do we, when do, why are we starting to take advice from four-year-olds? Well, like, four-year-olds don't get to decide if they eat their peas or their carrots, or if they do, go to school or homeschool, whatever you do. You know, they don't get to decide that stuff because they're 4 years old. And what disturbed me so much is that you have this veneer of love, right? And we're going to love on you and accept you and that kind of thing. And yet they were pushing this little boy towards just like changing his gender or identifying as a different gender, when you wouldn't trust a kid. Look, when I was 4 years old, I pretended to be a hippopotamus, right? Like, I was a lion on Tuesday and then I was a bear on Friday. Like, it's not like you all of a sudden say, oh my goodness, is that true? Like, okay, well, we need to figure this out. Okay, what's your new, your new identity is going to be as a dog. Okay, well, I guess that's what you want to be. We get you dog food. We'll call you Rover. And it's like, what? We don't trust four-year-olds like that, because parents are given the responsibility by God to train up the child in the way they should go. We have shirked that responsibility because we have bought into lies that whatever you desire or whatever you want is good, instead of looking to our foundation in the scripture. Because in the scripture, we learn that men and women are both created in the image of God, but they are different and they are distinct. And God created us with a purpose, with design. We were not an accident. God didn't make a mistake. And so living in that reality, understanding that God has put a calling on our lives, that we should actually deny ourselves, not give in to every desire that we want, but actually deny ourselves, pick up our cross and follow him, living in that new reality, that's the methodology and the message that we ought to be teaching our kids and raising them up in and discipling them up in. Not, oh, you know, you can change your gender if you feel like you're a girl on Tuesday. Maybe you feel like a guy on Wednesday. Okay, we can do that too. This is sick. This is twisted. This is not right. This is heartbreaking, actually. Then What do we have? Like, what are we doing if we can't speak up about this? And look, I don't know how YouTube is going to react to this video that I'm making. I don't really care. Because all I know is that if we truly love that little boy, if we truly love him, then we'll want what's best for him. And what's best for him is what God has designed him for. If we truly love that mother, we ought to be praying that she comes to a place of repentance. I don't know what's going on in her head, whether it's this weird, like, it had been a trend for a long time, these mothers basically trying to convince their little boys that they're little girls because they wanted a little girl. And that's what happens when we become unhinged from moral foundations found in God's word. Because if morality is simply subjective, then doing whatever you want is completely acceptable, because there is no right, there is no wrong, there is no ought or should. It's just preference. But you know that's not true. Even if you're watching this right now and you think transgenderism, like, that's whatever, the you do you, all that, like, I have to believe that you believe there is some sort of stance or standard of morality. The question is where do you draw those lines? And the problem with morality being connected to culture as a moral standard, like, so whatever the mass majority of people believe, is that shifts over time. That shifts based on culture. And we know that can't be true, because there are some cultures that do evil things, even though the vast majority of people believe that's true. Like in cultures where they have child sacrifice. You know that's wrong. You know that's wrong. But yet, in that culture, it's understood as something virtuous, something good. So obviously, morality is not based on the culture itself. It needs to be on something outside of that. And what I'm going to offer to you is that our morality is founded, needs to be founded on the Word of God. Because it is in our heart, but we suppress that truth in unrighteousness. Our culture really celebrates confusion. It does. Like, if you're confused about who you are and your identity and all that, like, it celebrates that. But God has given us a firm identity when we enter His family. The Bible says we are all children of wrath, but through Jesus' sacrifice on the cross, we can enter His family and become His children. And now our identity is tethered to Him and who He says we are. Not just who we feel we are. For you watching this now, you may be caught off guard and you may see, hey, look, yeah, this is not good. This is not good at all. This is heartbreaking. This is disgusting. And yet you may still feel like you have no ability to be a light in this kind of darkness. The world sees this, what was in this trailer, as good, as holy, as just an amazing, loving thing. And yet it's not. And yet in reality, it's the exact opposite. And so speaking into that culture is not going to be easy. It's not. But I would encourage you that our calling as disciples is not one of just worldly comfort. It is a stepping into courage because of what Christ has already done for us. Our response to His sacrifice ought to be the submitting of our life and our pride and our reputation. I hope you got something from this video. God bless.